tears come out. I'm like, nah, I can't do that. How animators created the Spider-Verse. Let's watch this. Hey, your vacation ends at the end of this month. Let's go. Spider-Man.
My name is Danny Dimmel.
You're the only person I know that's happy that their vacation is ending.
Joshua Beveridge. I was head of character animation on Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse.
Yeah, Spider-Verse actually did something really good with movie animated movies. It changed the style because a lot of movies used to like always go for like this like realistic, like, you know, I don't know how to explain it, like this Pixar like animation look. And what Spider-Verse this is, they made it more about like the style of the animation and like the personalization of it. And a lot of movies are like going that route now, and I think it's really good. You get a more creative look into an animation like that.
I'm pretty sure you know the rest.
When we started the film, we really didn't know what we wanted the film to look like. We didn't know what our inspiration was. We all loved comic books, and we went back and we looked at comic books to see what was special about them. We fell in love with the half-toning, the hatching, and the line work. We were really inspired by Jack Kirby's illustrations. He has the Kirby Crackle or Kirby Dots that he uses a lot.
He uses
dots as a motif through the entire
movie.
And a lot of the techniques or visuals
that looks crazy.
The comic books were printed. We wanted to stay away from anything that was soft or did not look like it belonged in the illustrated world. That included motion blur.
Demon Slayer. I watched
the,
it.
The camera focus.
Well,
so one of the great things about this movie,
I watched Demon Slayer season one, and then I just read the whole manga because they take forever.
Because it all feels like it's printed in ink. I mean, you could
I figure that when they did the Spider-Verse, they were clearly inspired by the comic books.
From and going to, it looks like an illustration.
Send it in the chat. I'll react to it. And the music for this movie was lit too, bro. I love the music.
I love because we got to do this one at the very, very end of the movie. We did that one specifically so late because the song was being written while we were making it. So we actually started animating before the song he's singing to was finished.
I really like this song by Swae Lee and Post Malone. I need to rewatch this movie. I really like Spider-Verse.
Motif-wise, the goal for this scene is to make him feel as like in his element as possible. That he's in his neighborhood. He loves this place and he's comfortable there. It's a very inviting place. So the palette, the lighting, it's a comfortable, safe space.
I like Meet Kanye in videos.
This starts to get contrasted as we go to his school, where the lighting starts to get a little harsher and we kind of leave some of the comfort of his environment.
I'm gonna react to this last few videos and then I'm gonna go play again.
New York is an iconic part of the movie.
Yeah, way that they animated this show was beautiful, bro.
To treat New York the way only animation can, treat it like it's a character. And not just the whole city of New York, but the boroughs itself, we treated like different characters. Manhattan was this exaggeration of scale and light and brightness. The shot where Miles is leaping off the building.
That's all it is, Miles. A leap of faith.
It has an illustrated feel to it, and it starts with
this movie was beautiful, bro.
On their own, kind of look broken.
This movie
was beautiful. All the buildings are portions that don't make sense for New York. And
bro,
skewed in a way.
That shit is amazing. That shit was beautiful. I remember watching this shit. Es como tú, hermoso. Hey, don't try to risk me up. Don't talk to me like that. Me vas a hacer enrojar.
Buildings were miles long. There were, we had buildings that were maybe 8 to 10 times taller than they should be for New York in shots. They're also weirdly composed so that...
All right, Carl, take your time.
When you see it from the shot camera, it all looks really...
Yeah, this show
looks
cool.
Really cool.
Really
you pull from the side and you view it through a witness camera, you can see that not only are the buildings very strange proportions, but the layout is really messed up. It's really weird, broken looking. But from the camera, it's an amazingly powerful shot.
Yeah, it really was.
What you're seeing
it
here is
amazing.
A test environment. Some people might look at the train, some people might look at Miles. You're seeing the color shift in and out registration. The way that the
so they're trying to make it look like a comic book
lined up properly. So it definitely puts one area in focus, but at the same time, it still avoids that lens feel or the softness.
So this sequence is we called sitting back there, and it's really the first time we see Miles and his dad really interacting in the movie. That first shot of this run, where they're rounding the corner in front of that TV screen is a great example of offsetting the characters in the foreground so you can pay attention to the screen in focus.
Yeah, that's cool.
This one test shot, but one of the key things we really discovered from it was how much we could deconstruct the level of detail at a distance. If you look really closely, all of the traffic in this image behind that one passing lane is all just simple color blobs. Mm-hmm. And those simple color blobs represent a full city. And it was a great aha moment for the entire team that we weren't going to populate it with 1,000 cars and full of every single light in there.
We took that idea and we applied it to a lot in the movie, including every interior.
And it's a great example of handling level of detail in a way we hadn't traditionally.
This was different. I remember when this movie came out, like, it really changed a lot.
Populate every building with people and just get that reduced later. It was color blobs. And then we were looking for opportunities to make things simpler in animation all throughout the movie. Sometimes, like, even we'd have characters flashlights. And if you didn't see them, we didn't animate them. That concept became the starting ground for another test. If you notice really closely on the bus that's crossing the scene, it's actually just a deconstructed painting. There's not 40 characters all sitting within that bus.
Oh, wow, really?
Pop frames in it where it's just hand-drawn, and it's really simple, and it could be basically taken out of a simple comic. We're starting to realize that we have an opportunity.
That really made it feel like a comic book.
Create
for
a new visual language.
Is one of those things we had to solve a lot of different ways.
No me acuerdo. Yo lo que sé que gano un premio, pero no.
For a furrow or a dimple can make you feel completely different about the expression. Form lines to describe the shape of something. A thing like a nose. The effects team did this amazing thing where we had the character designer make a library of drawings. So that was something we could make rules for. This is the way that nose would look from this head angle to camera.
So they're using the nose as a center so that it like changes the way that the character looks.
Recreate those in 3D space with those rules of head angle to camera, and then let the machine learning program track where those drawings would go. And a person would correct it every time it was wrong.
I haven't watched Klaus.
And little by little, we're teaching the computer to make drawings that we find redundant. So like an example like where Miles is scrunching his face right there.
That's funny.
Usually the characters like this, you'd have to be wrinkling the model in order to get this sort of crease.
Toy Story, can I get terminado, bro? I don't know whether making a Toy Story 5
and it's
or 6
or whatever. More expressive and we understand it. It's more...
Yeah, I agree. It really makes
all that technology was in the service of allowing artists more freedom to do things by hand, and it all,
and the thing all, is all it's good that they did this because the ground they set in the groundwork for like other people who use this kind of style I like, you know, learn from this to like make a similar like feel to something like this
crafted feel,
even if it looks different it could use the same like
that's
you know
not even how the saying goes.
Yeah. Super recomiendo. Klaus, okay.
Early on
de que se trata?
Animating on twos was gonna be a great solution for a couple of reasons. If you just watch it at speed you're just immersed in the movie, you're not noticing all these things, they're really sneakily hidden in there. But if you
okay
pause
it's
a
Netflix
screen,
I could watch it
only every other frame Miles is animated.
Yo te aviso,
that's what
entonces,
we're describing as
yo la veo.
You get that nice crispness that pop art
that Netflix I might watch it
almost every shot in the movie the cameras are on once, so we had to come up with all kinds of different technical solutions for how to make our performances with our characters on twos work with different styles of camera always on ones.
Bro, no wonder this movie won an Oscar. Holy
shit, they put in work, bro. You can see he's going in and out of sync with the camera. If the camera's moving at high speed through this handheld ones.
They put a lot of work into this
Peter
shit.
Miles, they're both usually animated on twos, but we're going in and out of sync with them just so you're getting that sort of feeling of they're not quite on the same page. The real goal with this
second that's
is
good
to make
that they
Miles
did that.
Feel like he's getting it. Miles is not quite in his element. He hasn't learned to be a hero yet. He hasn't figured out how to web
swing. I like the J's, though. The J's.
He starts really out of sync.
Yo hice una animación hace una semana.
His,
oh, tú animas.
And this being his
de que se trataba la animación.
Deal for him.
And I don't think I ever animated anything.
Seeing the two of them get on the same page.
Animating takes forever.
It'll get into sync with
solo dura dos segundos, and okay.
They're even on different.
Yo sé que Animal dura demasiado dependiendo and que tú quieras hacer con la animación.
Twos, we get to clarify that sort of posing.
Okay.
Peter doing the iconic.
De vez en cuando yo también hago cosas así. Damn, bro, he got no shoes on.
Gets to get there by the end of it. And then you see them make eye contact and bond.
Maybe the little things that they did that made the movie feel really wholesome.
And then you can see Peter glitch here. He's not supposed to be in this Spider-Verse. And so all the superheroes that come to this Spider-Verse from theirs, they struggle with this dimensional glitching.
Hey, guys.
Okay, who are you?
Oh, that's what that was, the little glitch thing.
How many spider people are there?
So I remember that.
In each of the
a mí me gustaba dibujar hace mucho, pero no tengo tiempo. As
different as possible, while still standing next to each other and looking like they looked good next to each other. There was the
Peter Parker,
handsome Spidey. The goal with him was how perfect of a hero could we make him that was going to be a great role model for Miles, and then take him away.
And we replace him with Peter B. Parker or Burrito Peter.
This fry is your universe. It's soggy. It's weird. It's gross.
He's no longer in his prime. He maybe should be retired by now.
He's lost a few more fights.
He's lost a lot more fights. He's a reluctant mentor.
You have money, right? I'm not very liquid right now.
I think you're going to be a bad teacher.
And there's Gwen Stacy.
Wanda?
It's Gwen, actually.
Gwen Stacy is of all the people, the
hero. Licking your fingers and shit.
She is capable and adept and in charge.
I mean, it depends what I'm meeting. But the food is hitting, hey, it's hitting. I said, you know, the burger was fire.
Spider Noir,
hey, fellas.
He was a menace to fucking
black
society.
And white, even in our world, he never does get any color. He has the best one liners.
Wherever I go, the wind follows.
That was, wind was crazy. It was like cold. Rain. It was
Penny
cold.
Parker.
Hi, guys.
Para disfrutarla, claro.
Penny Parker was. The only
comértela como
that doesn't
quieras.
Have superpowers of her own, and she
yeah, she has a fucking robot.
A telekinetic relationship with a spider that runs her robot named SPDR that her father created.
This could literally not get any weird.
Huh?
Spider-Ham. Wacky Spider-Ham.
Yeah, he's the most who we're trying to be.
Carta roja, suspensión del jugador.
He's got a giant hammer that he pulls up.
That's some gay shit.
My name is Peter Parker.
Characters like
Peter Parker,
Miles, Peter, and Gwen, they all came from the same physical universe where like the laws of reality were all somewhat similar. And more extreme characters like Ham and Noir, and especially
yeah, the cartoon
Parker,
ones were crazy. I don't know how
them,
they
like,
did
how
them.
How differently could we make them?
For the final battle, the wheels fall off. We've turned everything to 11.
Yeah.
Everything is going nuts. So we have this abstract.
The final battle was crazy.
Kind of inspired by Kirby dots. The Kirby dots are not just an aesthetic thing. They're a nod to the collider beam, which is a particle beam. And depending on what's happening and which characters are important, the palette is shifting based
really
on the colors and the worlds of. Or the Spider-Verse colors of those characters.
That end fight was crazy.
And then when you get to the most emotional part where it's just Miles and
getting
and
like darker and darker.
You know, this is the final moments of the final.
Kingpin
battle.
Looked like a toe, like
colored.
A big
it's
toe.
Black. The Kirby dots are now just volumes of nothing.
Enveloping
them. And it becomes really just about them. And it also sets up.
And that show was
incredibly
crazy.
Beautifully.
I really enjoyed this
the
movie
contrast
for real.
Of when Miles finally uses his superpower with the touch. You've now established this black background for this beautiful strike of his.
Te amarran y te dan vuelta y te tiran.
This was a special project.
This movie was fun. I really enjoyed it.
You really get to do something new.
It had to be bold. It had to be different. And that was a demand the audience put on us before we even started.
Really, everybody held hands from the very beginning to try to do something special and to try to push animation somewhere where it hadn't been before.
Yeah. That's Fox. No tengo padre. Damn. Un chiste oscuro. Yeah, I really enjoy that shit.